Hi everyone, welcome back to Get Ready With Me, Louise. So I'm so excited because I did get my hands on the new Wet n Wild collection. The Melody, My Melody and Kuromi? I'm not for sure on it. I do kind of remember the My Melody, but that's about it. I don't remember the other one at all, the Kuromi. So it came with two eyeshadow palettes, a blush and highlighter palette, and I think two liquid lipsticks. And I got one, I got the My Melody one. I didn't get the Kuromi one, so that's why we got this look. Kind of goes with the palette. This is the palette we're gonna be working out of today. This is what it looks like. It's very vampy, fall, darker. And this is the Kuromi. And then the My Melody one looks like this. And it's more light, spring, summer, you know, bright colors. We will be working on that. And then this is the liquid lip that went with it, with the Melody one. And this is the blush and highlighter palette. Now these two here go with the Kuromi, the highlighter and blush. And then these two here go with the Melody one. And I am wearing these two here today, the Kuromi one. And it also came with the most adorable brush. What is it? Here it is. I didn't know. I'm sorry. I don't know where I put the brush. But it's just adorable. It's got like little sparkles in it. I mean, it's just so adorable. I love it. So anyway, we are going to be playing, like I said, out of the Kuromi palette. I don't know where I put that brush. I wanted to show it. But my daughter's already taken it because I was supposed to film this like a long time ago and I just never got around to it. So this is the eye look we're going to be creating today, and it's way outside my comfort zone, okay? Wait, this whole look is outside my comfort zone. That's why I chose it to do first. So the first shade I'm going to go into, because we're just going to get started. This, I knock everything over, because you just know I'm going to knock everything over before I even get started. You know what I mean? Oh, forget it. It don't even matter, really, does it? I mean, I just knock it over, pick it up later, right? Alright. So the first shade we're going to go into is this yellow one right here. And it's a matte. And I'm going to use the JH30 brush. And we're going to start to create our crease. I've already primed my eyes with the, Hourglass Primer. And it does build the color. You can build them, okay? You can. But as you blend them, they seem to go away. I'm not gonna lie. Now, I don't play that much with drugstore palettes. I'm not gonna lie. And reason being is because I feel like, and I know I'm wrong with this because I know they're out there, but I just feel like they don't have the same color that a more expensive one has, I guess is what I should say, or a name brand one has. And I know that's not true, don't get me wrong, I know, but it's just the way I feel, you know? But I was, trying my very best though to use this palette because I do like the colors, and if I'm going to play in colors and get used to colors, like, I don't want to go into my more expensive palettes. But yet I feel like if I'm going to learn, I'd rather have the good shadows to learn from, you know what I mean? I mean, I would assume that I could be wrong, obviously. But like I said, I'm just creating that crease because I have hooded eyes. So it's a struggle. Especially with someone that has no experience at all doing makeup, it could be a very big struggle. I'm not gonna lie there either. But I feel like if I can create a look having no makeup experience and having the issues that I have, then anybody can. And you can sort of see that yellow building up. But like I said, I don't need it to be that, you know, pigmented, because it's just my transition shade. It's just something to sort of, you know, go into the next shade, in a sense. Not, I mean, I do want it to be something, don't get me wrong, but... And I've really been, like, playing with certain, these brushes here, to get a feel for them, because I know that tools make a difference, and I'm trying, like, to figure it out for good eyes. It's not easy. But I do feel like you can create a lot of good looks using these palettes. I just feel this is more nostalgic than it is makeup, if that makes sense. It's more for the people who love these particular characters. But regardless, the color selection they chose is amazing. And I had a lot of fun creating that eye look on, you know, this eye. Alright, now that I got that blended in, pretty much the way I want it. I can always go back if I need to. Well, I have to go back to make sure the other colors are blended. I'm going to go in with the JH35, and I'm going to go into this matte grayish color, stone almost, and I'm just going to go right under what I just laid down. Just to really get that crease to pop. And to go, you know, go a little darker so that the next shade has something to come into, you know? I will say that because I am new, I do like the way these shadows apply and stuff, because if you go and apply too much, it is very, very easy to blend it out. I will say that. And that goes with the blush and the highlighters. Same way. If you over apply, easy to blend. And it's also easy to build color too, I can't deny that. But you can see that, like, they blend well in together. The two shades I've already applied. And then I'm just going to go ahead. Actually, I need to darken it up a little bit. And then my problem is also, which I'm pretty sure a lot of people have this issue, one eye is more hooded than my other, you know? So that really makes a difference too, and I gotta keep it sort of like looking, going, okay, did I get it right, you know? I have been having a lot of fun with these palettes. I mean, it kind of is a first impression, but then I kind of played with it so I know what I'm telling you, that way I'm not leading you the wrong way, you know what I mean? Because I don't want to lead anybody into buying stuff they don't need. Now I want to concentrate this on just the very outer. And this is the matte dark purple in the palette. And I'm going to pat it on first. And then I'll start to blend it. Oh, and this is the JH33. I really do feel like they need to make these numbers bigger for us blind people. You know? And if you're really wanting to concentrate, I would suggest the patting, you know? Pat it on and then blend. Because if you go in just blending, you're going to be waiting a long time to build that color up. Just so you know. And there's nothing wrong with that. But I know that, you know, some people just don't have all day to do that. So I'm just giving you a heads up on it. But you can see how easily it is to blend these colors together. Well, I'm assuming you can see how easy it is to blend these colors together. Fun. I just enjoy playing with makeup. It makes me feel so much better. Especially the last couple days, it's been a mess. And though I haven't been able to film, I have been able to at least put on the makeup, so it's made me feel really good. And when I say makeup, I just mean on, you know, eyeshadow. Eyeshadow makes me happy. Lipstick makes me happy too. But eyeshadow more. Alright. I'm going to take the same brush and run that purple on my lower lash line. And connect it. And I did water my waterline with a ColourPop gel liner. It's a dark purple. I'll tell you in a minute what it was. I forgot now. I usually know one by heart because I don't have that many of them. But I really do enjoy the ColourPop gel liners. I'm not gonna lie there. They're nice eyeliners. It is in the color Charmer. That's what I got on my waterline. Alright, I'm going to go back into that gray. Darken it up a little bit more. Now it looks more darker over there. With that gray the way it is. Just needed more gray. Then I'm going to go back into that first shade, the yellow, and just make sure that the gray is now. Pretty much just back and forth, you know, until like both eyes are like the same, which is not easy. You have no experience, it's quite hard. I mean, I take that back. If you have no experience in like makeup is a thing. Now I'm going to go into that dark gray and I'm going to line, take the pencil and line my waterline, or not waterline, under my waterline, lash line, with that gray. What I used in the beginning. Then I'm going to take, hold on just a second. That was a JH38, just so you know. Yeah, you're looking good. Both sides are safe. Then I'm going to take the JH41, spray it with my Max Fix Plus, and go into this shimmery purple red. Well, very, very. And I'm going to start to pat that all the way on my lid to my crease. And I really do like this brush for this reason. It gets right in there and follows my crease really good. And I'm going to take it over right about there. And I'm kind of like patting this feet, you know, pat feet. Like that. Then I'm going to take the JH42, spray it with Max Fix Plus, and go into this really, really shimmery lilac purple color and put it in my inner corner. Inner corner. And it is so pretty. I mean, you could use this palette and make a very light look too, don't get me wrong. It doesn't have to be a vampy look. That's just the vibe I got out of it. Take my Hourglass flatliner brush in a angled liner brush in the number 10, and I'm gonna spray it, because what I've done was took this one shimmer color and black with the most purple, really. It's a dark purple one. It's gonna glitter through it, and I line my lash line. Kind of just pushing it in there because I just felt the glitter is everywhere. Let me down my face. I just wanted to see what it would do as a liner. I think it'd be great as a shadow though. I'm almost out of my max plus. I have extras though, don't worry. But I don't have that much extra. I need to buy some more. Now I'm going to do it same for my lower lash line. Good. Then I need to brush it, make sure there's nothing there, because I'm gonna tell you that stuff. Whew, it's glittery. So when it falls, it falls. I know it's in my lashes, that's why I was moving. So then I'm going to take my lash curl and I'm going to curl my lashes. And I'm going to use the new Pat McGrath mascara. The Dark Star. Kind of been liking it. A little bit anyway. I'm still playing with it. I like it. I know I like it. But I haven't really got my opinion yet. I'm still working on it. But I do like it. Because it does give my lashes volume. is the final look. So as you can see, it didn't take me too long to do that. It took me longer to think of the colors because, you know, I'm not good with colors. But, and again, this is more way outside. Like, darker shades just aren't my thing. Although, I do find this very pretty. And I do feel like you could take this palette and make it lighter shades if you chose to. I just chose to go in more vampy routes. I'm wearing a darker color, so, for an outfit, so why not, you know? Why not play and have fun? So, this is what the final look looks like. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, go ahead and give me a thumbs up and subscribe and ring the bell. That way you're notified when I do upload. Again, I'm just a consumer giving my opinion on a makeup product that, you know, I don't have any experience. And I pay for those stuff myself. All of this stuff. I pay for myself, okay? So, you know, if you ain't got experience, then, you know, or if you do have experience, but maybe you're slightly better than me, or maybe you're slightly, you know, not, then you know where you stand on if you can work with the product or not. Again, I think it was cute. I think this is made for the people that this era, you know, was nostalgic for. But all in all, very cute. Like it. Love it. No, don't love it, but I do like it. And it is cute. I do think it's definitely adorable. So, I will see. I will probably do the Melody palette next. And then I think I got some newer stuff coming, I think. I hope. If not, we'll dig back in and see what I got and film something on something old that you may already have that you forgot about. But I will see you in my next video. Stay safe and stay healthy. Bye.